Hello friends, welcome to Java training session 13. This is Haradhan once again to let you know the importance of single dimensional array in Java. So what is array in Java? Array is a collection of similar type of element that have contiguous memory locations. An array is a very common type of data structure wherein all elements must be of same data type. Once defined, the size of the array is fixed and cannot increase to accommodate more element. And index for the array start from 0 to n minus 1. So in array, you can store only similar type of data. Like in case we have declared the array type as integer, only we can store integer value. Similarly, if we declare the array type as string, so we can store string data type, and the size of the array is start from 0 and it will n minus 1. That means in case if we define the array size as suppose 5, so it will start from 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so that way array behave in Java. We can store only the fixed size of element in array. It does not grow its size at runtime. So that is one kind of problem is there for the array, because as and when we are defining the size, it cannot be increased, okay, and it also it cannot be decreased also. So it will be fixed and its value cannot be changed during runtime. So to solve the problem, collection framework already introduced, where I will show you that how we can handle the runtime size related stuff. There are two types of arrays there in the Java. One is single dimensional array. Example is given 1, 2, 3, 4, only single dimensional, and the multi-dimensional array, right? I have to given two dimensional examples, two dimensional will be there. Using an array in a program is a three-step process. First, we need to declare the array data type, suppose the integer type array. Then we need to construct the array, what are the size will be there, we need to provide. Then we need to initialize the array. That means we need to provide the value for the array's element, right? So I will show you how array actually works in Java. So here I already created a project Java training session 13 under the package training, and in the project Java training project. So first I will show you how we can define an array. Okay, suppose I want to define an array. Only here I need to only construct an array, okay, by getting the data type is the value initially. Okay, so how can I construct an array? Suppose I want to construct an array integer data type, integer a, then third bracket. Here I will declare the only the size of the array element. Suppose new integer, and here I will provide the size. Suppose size I want to provide as suppose 3, right? Okay. So array size I already fixed. Okay, that means here first two already declaring the array type, which is the integer type, and then the constructing the array, right? I am just declaring the size as 3. So what does it will work? So it will start from 0, 1 and 2. So total 3 field I want to store in the array. Then I need to initialize the value of the array, right? How we can initialize? A 0. I want to store the value of in the 0th element as integer, right? It is integer data type, so I want to store as 10. Then similarly for second element, right? A 1 positions, and I want to store as suppose 20. Okay, equal to I need to provide. And then similarly for the third element, I want to store as 30. Okay, so that's why you can declare the array type, construct the array and initialize the value of the array. Now if you want to print a particular element value, how we can print it? You need to use the SOISO method. Then you need to use the array, right? And you need to enter the positions. Suppose I want to enter the position as 1, right? That means that second value, right? Second element. Okay, if you run the code, it will give you the sorry, here it is, in it entered 2, we have entered 3, that is the reason it is throwing some error. Okay, you can see like, I mean, out of index, out of bound exception, because that 3 is not, should not be there, because array size is 2, I mean 3, and we can maximum, it will allow the value as 0, 1 and 2. Okay, so right now if you run it, you can see, it will display the correct output, right, the second element, that means one position, starting from 0, one position. Similarly, you can print the first element. Right? And you can also get the second element. Right? Third element. Using the... So A3 will not work because that is not there. Right? You can see some error message is coming. Array index out of bound exception, because that is not there. Right? We have given the array size as 3, so it will start from 0, 1 and 2, so it A3 will not be allowed. Okay, so if you want to print that, I mean A3, so you need to declare, change the, array size as 4, and then you need to add some another element here at the fourth position, right? So using the 3. Okay, and if you change the value, you will see it will give you the correct output. Okay, and one interesting thing is that in case you are defining the size of the array, right, and after that if you are not filling any element, so it will take the default value of the data type. Suppose here I have declared the value, I mean size of the array as 4th, right, and I have only declared, I mean initialize, right, two value for first position, 0th position and 2nd position, right? That means 1th position. For 3rd and 4th element, I did not initialize any value. So, in case you are not initializing any value, as the size is fixed for the integer array, which is the size of 4, right? So, in case you are not declaring, so it will take the default data type value. That means for integer, default data type value is 0. So, here if you want to print the value of 4th element, it will show you 0, because in for 1 and 2 I have just only defined the value, right, initialize the value. For 3rd and 4th I did not initialize any value, so it will take the default value of the integer data type. Similarly, you can see, right, also 0, right? And so in case you want to print the second value, right, A1 positions, it will show you correct output 20. Okay, so that's why you can print a particular value. Okay, now if you want to print all the values, right, you need to use the for loop. So how can I use that? For the, you need to, using the for loop, you know, right, you need to declare some, integer type I equal to starting with 0, and it will go till I less than a dot length. So it will check the length of the, so length is 4, so it will go to 3rd, right? That means it is starting from 0, 1, 2, 3. So it will, it will check the value of the array, right? Then I less than, and then I plus plus, okay. Then here you need to just print out the value. SYSO. What is the value? A, and within the bracket we need to enter I, right? What is the error? It is coming. Create a local variable. Okay, so I need to declare the variable type as int. Okay, so using for loop, you can print the value of the array, right? If you run it, you can see all the arrays value will be printed out, right? So here we have declared the value of two elements, the first and second element, and the rest two. I did not declare anything, so that is the reason default value is coming. Okay, so if you declare the value again, so it will display the correct. So I am just declaring the second value as 30 and the fourth position's value as 50. Say okay. So if you run it, you can see this, displaying the correct output, right? Now you can change the value, right? Suppose 6. Okay, and I have declared only the 4. I have initialized only 4 variable, right? So the next two, 5th and 6th element, it will take the default value 0. Okay, you can see. That's why you can increase the size of the array also. But as you are defining the size, so it will fix size during runtime in case you are not initializing any value for the element of the all sizes. So it will take the default value of the data type declared for the array. Okay. And also similarly, I can print the array using the enhanced for loop, right? In the for loop discussion, I already showed you the for loop. Okay. But I just, for loop in, in our different kind of loops, so I already discussed, but I did not discuss the enhanced for loops. So I already told, right, for enhanced for loop will be only applicable for kind of printing array. Okay, until you are not clear about the array, so it will be not be possible to you understand the enhanced for loop. So using the enhanced for loop, I can print the array also. So what is the syntax for enhanced for loop? For, then you need to declare the data type based on the array's data type. Suppose integer, I am declaring a some variable, suppose integer 1. Then you need to, give the semicolon, then you need to give the array's name here. So, after semicolon, you need to give the array's name. Then, second bracket, SYSO, then you need to print that particular int 1, right? So, that is the enhanced for loop. So instead of that for loop, you need to declare a initialize a another variable where you will store the value of array A, right? And then you can simply print it. So that is the advantages of inner for loop. No need to use the total for loop. Okay. So if you run it, so it will show you the same output, right? 10, 20, 30, 50, and the 5th and 6th one is 0. No, because no value was entered, right? So that's why you can print, right, different types of integer type, you can print the different value, right? Suppose I also entering the two others values here, element value here. Suppose integer 4 equal to 20 or say 15, and integer variable value 6 element is suppose 5, say. Okay, if you run the code, you can see that it will display the correct output, right? 5. Right? Whatever was there, right? So it will display the correct output. Now, in case you want to sort the element, right? Right? So from ascending order, you want to sort the element. So whatever mentioned here, right? Java arrays classes provide a few utilities methods. One of the utility method is arrays.sort, which help you to sort the arrays of object. All the object can be sorted. So how can you sort it? Okay. Arrays dot sort. Right. Here add is integer type. You need to select that functions. Right. Sort. And here you need to give the integer name. Suppose I am giving the integer name. Right now, if you want to use the enhance for loop and you want to print the values of array, it will print the in sorting order, right? 5, 10, 15, 20, 30, and 50, right? Okay. So you can see that way also. I mean, array with data type integer is working fine, right? Now, I'm just commenting this particular code, okay? And here, I'm declaring another array where I will initialize the value, declare, construct, and initialize the value of the array in the same line, right? So how you can do it? Suppose I am declaring an integer data type array B. Here, in the same line, I am declaring initializing the value. So within the second bracket, you need to declare the value 1, 3, 5, 8, 90, 78, right? That's why you can initialize the value. Okay. Now, using the enhance for loop, right, here you need to change it to B, right, you can print the value of the array. You can see it will show you the correct output, right, 1, 3, 5, 8, 90 and 78, right. Suppose if you want to sort it, right, again you need to use the sort arrays dot sort integer data type, array is the integer data type, you need to use the B array, right? So if you sort, run the functions, you can see, right, it is sorted 1, 3, 5, 8, 78, 90, sorted out, right? Okay, so that's why, you can either declare and construct array in this line and you can initialize the value in other lines, or otherwise, you can declare, construct, and initialize the array value in a same line. Okay, and you can sort out using the arrays.sort. So I already discussed these are the integer data type array. Okay, now I will show you how we can use the string data type array. So for string data type, suppose I want to declare, construct, and initialize the string data type in a same row. Okay, so what is the syntax? String is equal to within the second bracket, right? Here, within the second bracket, you can construct, initialize the element, but as string, you need to use the string value in the different, right, in the double quote. Suppose I want to enter Java, okay, then I want to also use C, I want to use another object as Python, then say another one Ruby, then another one say Perl, right? So what is the value of the array? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So value of the array string with data type string is 5. So it will start from A0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like, so 5 it will not be printed. In the fifth positions it is the value of Perl, right? So it will start from 0 position and it will go to the 4th index, right? Suppose right now, if we want to print, suppose the value of Python, right? So you need to use the position as 12, 2, 0, 1, 2, S, and the position you need to enter as 2. So it will print you the Python, right? Let's see, let's run it, right? You can see. Suppose in case you want to print the value of Ruby, right? Then 0, 1, 2 and 3, you need to use the third, right? Okay, let's run the code. And you can see Ruby is printing out, right? So that is the one type. Now, if you want to print the all the value, right? So using the enhance for loop, you can print it out. So what is the syntax? Here, you need to first define the data type, right? You can see here, I have declared the data type as integer, but here it will be string, right? And the data type is string, so you need to use the string. Then you need to declare a variable. Suppose I am declaring a variable string, and then here you need to enter the right array's name. Okay, then you need to use the double bracket SOISO, and then you need to use the particular variable name. So it will print all the values. You run it, you can see, right? Java, C, Python, Ruby, and Perl, whatever was there, it is printing out. Now you can increase the value, increase the size of the array, right? Suppose I want to add another one, C++. Okay, now let's run it. Right? Okay, you can see all the output is coming. Java, C, Ruby, Python, Perl, everything is coming, whatever was there for the string, right? So that's way you can create different type of array using different data type. It can be string, it can be integer, it can be float, okay? And you can print a single element or multiple element, okay? And you can also print all the element using the for loop or enhanced for loop, right? So that's all about for the single dimensional array. So for multi-dimensional array, I will create a separate session where I will elaborate you different type of multi-dimensional array, the matrix, different matrix operation, all this stuff. Okay. So thank you all for watching my videos. In case you are enjoying my videos and learning automation testing in Java, do not forget to like, share my video and subscribe my channel. Please post your valuable comment for any input or suggestion. Stay tuned for my next video.